now that we talk about the importance of the privacy to blockchain, can you please elaborate on what are the key areas or what are the most important areas that needs privacy? For example, is it NFT, DeFi, gaming, on-chain voting, or anything else?
Yeah, I think all the use cases that you just described definitely benefit or derive some sort of value from privacy. For example, on the gaming side, right? Mm-hmm. Like with on-chain games right now, because the state of every single game, if you put it fully on-chain, would be publicly viewable to anyone, then you can only create certain types of games. For example, you can't create a strategy game. So for people who are familiar with like something as simple as poker or League of Legends, StarCraft, Age of Empires, right? These are all strategy games where every single player on the map, every single player that is, you know, in the game, has their own specific strategy, and they can't see what each other are doing. And so we can describe this as like a fog of war.
Right.
But without that layer of privacy, then you can't really have fog of war because anyone can check the state of the game on chain. Mm-hmm. And so now all the strategies are fully revealed. And so such a game like, you know, StarCraft or League of Legends, et cetera, can't really exist.
Yeah.
And so I think like that's a great example of like how gaming can even benefit from privacy, right? Not just, I think this brings up a really good point. And so I'm glad you brought up the question, because privacy is not just about like a user's transactions.
Right.
It can extend beyond that and, you know, really focus on the types of applications that can be developed in the space as well.
I guess the reason why people aren't realizing that is because a lot of those Web3 games, they're essentially very centralized. The servers, the data, but essentially if the skill or the games, they are moving towards more of the decentralized direction, then they will start to realize how important the technology for privacy is for them.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. And so that's why I like to think about, like, you know, what is not what blockchain looks like today, but what does it look like, you know, 5 to 10 years from now?
Now, till today, you have already worked on Manta Network for 3 years. Over the last 3 years, we have already seen a very bull market, and now it's kind of bearish or whatever you call it, crap. So do you think like for the next upcoming bull market, or within what kind of time frame do you think the adoption of the privacy technology will become flourished to a point that you will say, oh, the technology of Manta Network is really being used critically by users and by projects?
Yeah, I think you know, I can't give an exact timeline on this, but it's not just about Manta Network, but about the privacy space in general. I think during this time, right, during this recent bull cycle, a lot of projects, Manta Network, Aztec, Alio, et cetera, a lot of projects that are focused on privacy really started to, you know, build and iterate on this space.
Yeah.
And so I do think that we're all positioning ourselves to a point where, you know, once we hit the next sort of bull cycle potentially, right? Like we're at a great position to launch and really push that whole privacy narrative. I think one of the major barriers to privacy, which is why I really appreciate you having me on this podcast, is education and understanding of privacy, right? Like I think the normal conversation around on-chain privacy is very similar to how the conversation around Bitcoin was years ago, which is essentially, oh, you only use Bitcoin if you're going to do bad things, right? But now we see Bitcoin has evolved to, you know, a level where even institutional funds are trying to figure out their strategies around it.
Right.
It's really legitimized. And I think privacy is kind of in that infancy in conversation as well, right? Where it's like, oh, you're only going to use privacy if you do bad things. But I think throughout this conversation, we've been highlighting a lot of examples and use cases and like the necessity of it in the Web3 ecosystem.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, I think like in the next sort of cycle, I'm very excited for us, for a lot of other privacy projects to launch and really take that sort of privacy setting and conversation to the next level.